Hi everyone. If you are a civil engineer or you want to be a civil engineer one day, you probably know that you have to take some exams along the way to get certain certifications. So in this video, I'll cover the exams that you need to take as a civil engineer here in the United States. Let's go. So in this video, I'll discuss three exams: the FE, the PE, and the SE. And I'll explain what those acronyms mean. The first one is the FE, and this exam is the Fundamentals of Engineering exam. Let's go to the board. So the FE is the first exam. It is taken usually in your senior year of college, that's when you can take it, or after you graduate. The exam fee is $175 plus admin fees, depending on where you're taking the exam. And this exam is computer-based, so it's year-round. You can take it several times throughout the year. It's composed of 110 multiple-choice questions, and for the actual exam, you have 5 hours and 20 minutes. So if you do the math, that equals to about 2.9 minutes per question, so it's very fast-paced. The results you get in about 7 to 10 days, according to the NCES website, and I got my results, I think, the week after I took the exam. I took it in my senior year in college. And as you can see here, the pass rate is pretty high for the FE, actually. I believe this data is from last year, and about 3,900 people took the FE civil exam, and 69% passed, so it's a high passing rate. The FE is the first step in your licensure process. It's not a requirement for every company, but it's always a plus to have passed the FE going into the job market. Now, the PE exam. PE stands for Principles and Practice of Engineering. And this exam you can take after you pass your FE exam and you have experience. It's usually 4 years of experience if you don't have a master's degree, or 3 years of experience if you have a master's degree. However, in the last few years, a lot of states are allowing more people to take the exam early before they acquire the 4 years of experience, which was my case. So I took the exam before having 4 years of experience. I have about 3 right now. And you can check out my video where I talk about my study prep here, and then my other video about my results. And I just received my results a few days ago and I passed. But this exam you can take early. Regarding the exam format, right now it's still paper-based, but it's scheduled to be computer-based, just like the FE exam, next year. So you can see here this tentative schedule from the NCES website, and it says 2022. Before, it was later than that, I believe 2023 or 2024, but because of COVID, they're trying to make it computer-based quicker. As a disclaimer, this is just a tentative schedule, so they may change that if they can't make it happen by next year. For the exam fee, I don't know if it will change once it becomes computer-based, but I paid $350 to take the exam here in Florida. $250 was the exam fee and $100 of admin fee, which may change from state to state. The exam is composed of 80 questions. In my case, I took the civil structural exam. The morning, the AM portion, is the breadth portion, which is the same for everyone. It's general civil engineering, which covers all 5 areas of civil engineering: structural, geotechnical, transportation, construction, and water resources. Now, the afternoon portion is the depth portion, which it's going to be one of the 5 areas. In my case, I took the structural depth. It's 40 questions in the morning and 40 questions in the afternoon. So if you do the math, that winds up being 6 minutes per question. So you have a little bit more time than the FE exam, but the questions are a little bit harder. For the results, NCES currently states on their website that they release the results between 8 to 10 weeks after the exam. I got my results after 6 weeks. And for the PE pass rate, you can see here from NCES website that it's slightly lower than the FE. The pass rate, in my case for civil structural, it was 64%, and they break it down between first-time test takers and repeat test takers. And you can see that trend of repeat test takers, the pass rate is slightly lower in comparison to first-time test takers. The PE exam and the PE license are usually milestones in an engineer's career. For structural engineering, for example, it's a huge milestone because after you receive that license, now you can start stamping structural engineering projects or structural drawings and calculations. And the last exam I'd like to talk about is the SE exam. And it used to be called SE exam, but it's now called PE structural. The requirements for the SE are very similar to the PE exam requirements in the sense that you still need the 4 years of experience or three if you have a master's degree, and in some states you can take it early. The SE is mostly required by states in high seismic areas. For example, in California, I know Illinois also requires it, Georgia, I believe. So you need to go to the state board website and see the requirements there, what your state actually will require. The exam is longer than the PE. It's actually 16 hours, which is 2 8-hour days. The first day is just vertical forces, so just gravity. And then the second day is just lateral forces, which would be wind and seismic. And then on top of that, you also need to choose whether you're taking buildings or bridges. So in my case, if I were to take it, I would take the buildings portion. And then day one would be all vertical forces. In the morning, just general structural engineering. And in the afternoon, it would be buildings specific. The morning is multiple choice questions. The afternoon is not multiple choice questions. It's actually, you're gonna have to work out the problems. And the same goes to the next day. The difference is that it's all wind and seismic, lateral loads. It's a very expensive exam. It's $500 each, so you're looking at about $1,000 for both days, plus any admin fees that your state may require. So it's a lot of money. A lot of companies do cover your exam fees, however. But in light of all of this, I decided not to take the SE first and just go for the PE because there was a higher risk that I wouldn't pass the SE, and there was a lot of investment into it, plus Florida does not recognize the SE license. As far as the format goes, right now it's still paper-based, but as I said, NCES is moving towards computer-based for all exams. This exam, however, has questions that are not multiple choice, so it's going to be a little harder for them to move this exam to computer-based. So as you can see in the conversion schedule, this is the last one, and it even says TBD right now. For the pass rate, you can see here on NCES website that it's not very high. The highest pass rate is 51% for bridges, but it can be as low as 29%, as we can see here. So the SE exam is a really big deal because it's a very hard exam. People study more than double what they need to study for the PE, for the SE exam. So there's a lot at stake. The exam is double the time, and it's a huge milestone in a structural engineer's career. Now, if you're not working or don't plan to work on states that require an SE, it may not make as much sense to take it, just because if you take the SE, it's not going to give you any license. You won't be able to put the SE initials after your title or after your signature. However, studying for this exam, I'm sure, is extremely helpful for most structural engineers because you get to really understand a lot of structural engineering concepts and ultimately become a better structural engineer. Let me know if you enjoyed this video, this type of content, and feel free to give me suggestions in the comments below for future videos and what type of content you'd like to see on this channel.